Hi, and welcome to my playhouse. And today, I'm gonna be doing a little bit of maintenance work up here, because I have some solar collectors up there that produces hot water for my playhouse here. And, well, the system isn't entirely leak-proof, so over the year it loses a little bit of the fluids in there. I got a lot of crap for calling that solar fluids or something. I don't remember what I called it, but I was told that that was wrong. So today we're gonna go up there. Actually, we're gonna start in the basement and go up and fill on some more of this fluid that runs around in the solar collector system and heats the hot water in my playhouse here. So, yeah. Let's go see that. This is the controller for my solar collectors and pumping around the hot water in there. And there is not a lot of room here, but we can just see that right here it lights up. It has been running for 6,294 hours. And right now the temperature on the roof is 45 degrees. That's the water inside of it. And in here in the tanks, it's 39 degrees Celsius. And right now the pump is running, it's turning around. And you can also hear that. It also has a couple of meters showing the water temperature coming in from this pipe and going through, and the temperature of the water going out, which is this one, blue one. Just, and it kind of says 39 degrees in here, so it's kind of losing all the heat. So 45 degrees, it's a little bit cooler when it gets here. The pipes are pretty long and so on. So this temperature is a bit lower than the actual temperature up there. So the tank that it goes into is in the other room. Here is the tank that I heat up. It also has an electric heater right here. It runs off 400 volts. I think it's 3000 watts. And it also has a thermometer right here. It says that the temperature of the water up here is, what is that, 26 degrees? That's not the same thing, weird. Oh, no, 31 degrees at least. Okay, and the lower one down here is where the, that one is where the hot water from the solar collectors comes in, and that one is where it leaves again. So, okay. So that's the 300 liter tank that the solar collectors heat up on a good sunny day. So to keep this running smoothly, I want to make sure that the pressure is good. This one sounds absolutely empty. And it's a pressurized tank, which means that there's a kind of a balloon down here, and down here there is an air vent. And what it does, it takes in water, or the solar fluid thing that I'm not supposed to call it, and you put that in and you pressurize it by blowing up the balloon or expanding the balloon up to 2.5 bars. And what I want to do right now is make sure that there is enough of this solar fluids in their heating system fluid. So I'm gonna, well, let's turn off the thing here. Let's move that out of the way, move that one and detach it. There, system is off, and I will take the pressure out of it. That makes room for more of this, more of the fluids to go in there. And there wasn't a lot of pressure. That one is supposed to show me the pressure in the tank. And right now it's, well, just the white one over there. It's not even showing a bar or anything like that. So, okay. almost rid of the pressure here. And the water in the system will fall down here, and I'll be able to take out a little bit more pressure when it's has done that. That's good. Okay, here we are on this second floor. And on the balcony here, this table is in the way. And over here is the solar collectors. And I'm gonna be taking off this thing, which is an automatic vent. If there's air in the system, the air can seep out through that thing. And I'm gonna go find the fluids to put in there. So this is the thing that I'm putting in there. It's actually for cars, for the engine not to freeze up over winter. And this is good for down to minus 36 degrees Celsius. You can splice it with water. If you put in equal amount of water, it's good to minus 20 degrees. So I'm gonna dismount that over there and put in some of this. I have put a mattress down here. You're not able to see that, but it's for me to walk on because this roof is black and metal, so when it becomes hot, I can bend it too easily. I'm gonna take off this thing. It's very important to do this when it's not too hot. 44 degrees was what it was saying down there. And oh, that's the wrong one. I don't do this when the sun is very, very hot. Right now the sun is actually coming out again, so I have to hurry this up a bit. Here, that one off, and I have a funnel here to put in there, and I'm gonna take this cooler fluid. Oh, I should really have looked in the old video what people called it, but well, we're gonna pull this in. Okay, that wasn't enough, so I'm gonna go in and take some water to top it off. This is just regular tap water. Okay, I've actually filled it up now, and it's actually overflowing in rate of the solar panels heating up here and heating this cold water that I just pulled in. And it's bubbling a little bit, so I want to get this air thing on there right away. So we're gonna do that. Get that in there. So that it doesn't lose all the fluids that I just put in there. There. And I'm gonna tighten that. Okay, there is a picture of the mattress and me waving. And this is the solar collectors. And I built this setup myself. I didn't build the solar collectors myself, but I built the mount for them. This is years ago. That's before I started the YouTube channel, and one of the reasons that I really wanted to do a YouTube channel is because I was doing a lot of awesome shit. All the pipes here are just, well, laying there. It was just a good spot for getting things out of the way. So yeah, they are full. I have to go into the, down into the basement and turn on the system again and pressurize it so that this doesn't overheat. Okay, back down into the basement. And I'm gonna turn the system back on. There. And it comes up, figures out the temperature, 38. I did put in a lot of cold water on it, so it has probably went down in temperature. Yeah, right now the water in the tank is cooler than on the roof. Well, right now they're the same temperature. This controller, which is an Strise, S-T-E-C-A, Strise, I have no idea, TR0402, it doesn't start right away. I think the set temperature is 4 degrees or 6 degrees. So the temperature on the roof has to be 6 degrees higher than in the tank before it starts to circulate the water. But I have to pump some air in. Oh, this is heavy now. I think I put on about 4 liters of fluids. So, and a lot of it probably sit down here. So I'm gonna prepare my compressor. Okay, down here is my compressor. And we don't need that one. We need a gun like this for filling up your car tires. And I think this might just be long enough to go over there, but I have to pressurize this, and this is noisy. While charging the compressor, it actually started running here. You might be able to hear it. And the temperature raised up dramatically, 72 degrees Celsius, which means that there was a lot of hot air right there. Oh, there was a lot of hot water right there. So I'm gonna pressurize this a bit. I'm not gonna go up to 2.5 bar because I know this system is not really leak free, so I'm gonna go a couple of lines over there. There. Oh, that's actually 1.5 bar. Okay, so I'll go see if it pisses out everywhere. This place, the tank here, yeah, it has been leaking here before. That is actually where the tank temperature is measured. It's very dirty in here. The tank was too big for the basement, so I actually had to, saw out a big square in the floor here to make the tank fit here, because I bought this one and it was bloody expensive. But the water level is so high here that it's impossible to, keep it good. But nothing is pissing out. That was the point of this. And I can kind of see it out the window here and zoom in. And also kind of see that, that is also good. I might have to go up there anyway to check. It is bubbling a little bit around the automatic air thing here. That's the air getting out, so that's kind of a good thing. More important, the roof is kind of dry over here. We have had a bit of rain today, and it's also pretty clouded up there. So that's why I thought that would this would be a good time to fix this. There is a little bit of water down here, and that's because I spilled. I need to remember to get the mattress out of there. Oh. And it lives over here. So. Very, very old mattress. It's more or less only being used for fixing my solar panels. So right now it's saying 60 degrees up there and 40 degrees down here. So it might have helped too. And there is also a little screw over here at the on the side to take out the air in the system down here, so we're gonna turn that gently. I put on a little hose and that will run down here. and when the fluid starts to come out, I'll shut it off again. There. So, that's about it. Well, so hopefully the solar panels on the roof is ready to go for months and months and months. It's a really special feeling having them. I always cherish the first bath of the year. The first time in a year that I can fill up the tub and have a really nice solar warmed water bath. Mostly because it's free in some way. I know I paid for all this. This wasn't cheap. It was kind of, it was a rather big investment. I think there is for 4,000 kronas right here, and the solar collectors on the roof, though they were expensive as well. So, well, thank you very much for watching my videos. Do subscribe to my channel so that you can see me again, do something completely different the next time, and have a really nice day. Bye bye.